Hi, it's Dr. Z. I'll be discussing the three categories of psychoactive drugs, which I lovingly refer to as uppers, downers, and all-arounders. By the end of this video, you'll be able to describe stimulants, depressants, and hallucinogens. You will also be able to apply one or more of these psychoactive drugs to yourself for discussion board number three. Our first category is stimulants, or uppers. The root word of stimulant is stimulate, which means to increase or activate. In this case, a stimulant speeds up the activity of your central nervous system or your brain and spinal cord. The stimulation results in increased heart rate and breathing, as well as increased alertness and energy. At the same time, this increased energy often results in suppressing one's appetite. Caffeine is the most often used stimulant because it is found in food like coffee, tea, sodas, chocolate, and some over-the-counter drugs. If you've ever heard the complaint from former smokers about weight gain when they quit smoking, it is because nicotine suppresses appetite. Thus, when they're no longer smoking, their appetite returns. Amphetamines are made in laboratories and are used as the main ingredient in diet pills. Amphetamines also include methamphetamine, or meth, and crystal meth. And lastly in this category is cocaine. Cocaine is a highly dangerous drug due to its addictive properties. It produces feelings of euphoria, energy, power, and pleasure. It appears to act on the neurotransmitter dopamine. Our second category is depressants, or downers. The root word of depressant is depress, which means to decrease or inhibit. In this case, a depressant decreases the activity in your central nervous system, or your brain and spinal cord. In other words, depressants tend to slow you down and reduce sensitivity to pain or other sensations. As such, depressants can impair decision-making and coordination because your brain and spinal cord are processing much slower. The number one depressant is alcohol, as it indirectly stimulates the release of GABA. A myth of alcohol is that it makes you happy. Well, what it does is lower your inhibitions so you perceive yourself as happy. These lowered inhibitions often result in decreased motor skills, reaction time, and slurred speech. Barbiturates are known as major tranquilizers because they have a strong depressant effect. Sleeping pills falls into this category. Benzodiazepines are known as the minor tranquilizers because they have a relatively mild depressant effect. Drugs such as Valium, Xanax, Ativan, or lorazepam are used as anti-anxiety medication and/or as antidepressants. And last in this category is narcotics. Narcotics suppress the sensation of pain, thus this category includes painkillers such as opium, morphine, and heroin. Our final category is hallucinogens, or all-arounders. The root word of hallucinogen is hallucinate, which means to have an altered reality. In this case, hallucinogens alter and distort sensory perceptions. In other words, you perceive the world around you through a distorted lens, like things are fuzzy or moving slower or moving faster. Hallucinogens alter mood and produce feelings of unreality. Marijuana is the most commonly abused hallucinogenic drug. Marijuana tends to produce a feeling of well-being, mild intoxication, and mild sensory distortions or hallucinations. As a result, marijuana negatively affects reaction time and perception of surroundings. LSD is the most potent hallucinogen because it is manufactured in laboratories versus being found in nature like marijuana is. And designer drugs include ecstasy and MDMA because they're created in laboratories and are, quote, designed with greater highs due to incorporating stimulants into them. So those are our three categories. In addition, I have some big takeaways that I want you to take away from this video. First, recall that alcohol is a depressant. Now, what do people typically do when they're sad or depressed? They drink alcohol. Well, if you are depressed, the last thing you should be drinking is alcohol. Second, recall that stimulants increase your central nervous system while depressants slow it down. Now think about times when you've been drinking or seen others drink. What mixed drinks do people tend to have? Ever heard of Red Bull and vodka? Rum and Coke? Well, if you have a cocktail or mixed drink that contains both a stimulant and a depressant, you are screwing up your body, throwing it into two different directions. So do not mix stimulants and depressants. Third, because depressants slow your central nervous system down, the last thing you should do is combine multiple depressants in your body. That is why doctors recommend that individuals on anti-anxiety medications or antidepressants, like benzodiazepines, refrain from any alcohol use. If you combine multiple depressants, you could slow your brain and spinal cord down so much that your heart can stop beating and you can die. Our fourth is about a common misconception about marijuana. Marijuana, most people think it's a depressant because it, quote, calms me down or, quote, relaxes me. Well, what it really is doing is creating a sense of unreality, which is perceived as being more calm. Remember that it is a hallucinogen. Rather, chronic and long-term use of marijuana can result in paranoia, anxiety, panic attacks, and hallucinations. So takeaway number four, marijuana is not a depressant. Now, that brings us to discussion board number three. For discussion board number three, one of your questions will be, if you can be any psychoactive drug, what would you be and why? I look forward to reading your individual responses for discussion board number three.